Hey guys, hope you're so well. Today I thought it was time to do a video about the top 10 sandals for summer. I have had so many questions asking me if I can do this, so I thought I would round up the most on-trend sandals. We've got some high street, we've got some designer, and I will ensure that I link everything below, as well as dupes, because as we know, with all of these sandals, there are dupes, so more affordable versions as well. So get comfy and let's fire through these trends. Number one, the Gucci Thong Sandal. I'm obsessed with these sandals. They are so effortlessly beautiful. Yes, they have a big double G on them, but I like the branding being on there. I love the Gucci Marmont range. I'm literally obsessed with it. I have the brown version of these, which you can watch in my sliders video, which I will link below if you missed that last year, but they are just so effortlessly beautiful. I do like the thong sandal. I feel like they just go with everything. They're timeless. They look great with jeans. They look great with a dress. They're just really easy to wear, not too chunky, and just really nice and minimal, which I think is a real trend at the moment. You can get it in so many different colors. So if you've got the money, you can collect the whole range. I mean, I wish if someone wants to send me some, feel free to do that. But they have some cream ones, which I think are utterly divine for this year. And then they have the brown ones from last year. The fact that they've brought them out again just shows how popular they were. You obviously don't need to get these sandals in the Gucci version. If you would like to get a high street version, I will find some and link them below. But I personally just think they are such a beautiful, timeless, effortless designer sandal. Number two, the Miller Sandal by Tory Burch. I don't own any Tory Burch, but people are crazy for Tory Burch. Comment below and let me know, is this an American trend? Because in the UK, it's not really so much of a thing, but I am telling you, people are going crazy for the Tory Burch Miller Sandal this year. I think it will be because it's similar to the Gucci. It's that kind of beautiful thong look and it's really effortless, but then you've got a whack off logo in the middle, but it still looks really nice. I think the Tory Burch logo is so beautiful and it's kind of quite bohemian. So as much as you know that you're wearing kind of a mid-range designer piece on your shoe, it's also got that really nice style to it, so they can get away with putting a big logo on it. I also love the color in the light makeup shade. I just think it's beautiful and they look like really easy to wear soft sandals. Great for people who are wide-footed like me. They're also £185, so they are on the cheaper scale of the designer shoe price range, which is probably why people are going so crazy for them. Number three is a Chloe wide woody logo sandals. Oh my gosh, I love these so much. I have seen them all over Instagram. And again, they are something that has come back onto the scene from last year. I think it's kind of like Chloe maybe dipped the waters with it and were like, do people actually want this? And then they were like, oh my gosh, that sold out so quick. Everyone wants this. So originally I wanted the white ones. I just love how the strap crisscrosses over. Obviously, I'm a brand whore as well, so I love that it has the logo on. But the white seems to sell out everywhere. Like I said, everything that I mentioned on this video will be linked below. Just click show more. But I'm also going to link some other colorways as well. I noticed they have them in a full blacked out version. They are very cool. And they also have an orange version that's new for this year. So I feel like Chloe were just like testing the water and now they're like, yep, these look amazing. We're gonna bring them out in loads more colors. These come in at £284. So again, mid-range, a little more than your Tories, but less than the Gucci. So it's completely up to you. I know that some people probably just prefer Gucci and are very brand loyal to Gucci, but I just think these Chloe ones look really effortless. They're not thong, they're actually quite thick and chunky at the front with the logo and the bands. But I think it just looks really cool and I've not seen any other sandals like that really. Next up, the Hermes Oran Sandal. I couldn't do a video about sandals and not talk about these sandals. So what I want to say is I personally wouldn't buy these because everyone has copied them. And it's not about a copy. I completely agree with buying the actual designer version. However, £495 on a leather sandal that is quite plain is just one of those things that maybe if I did have the disposable income and I'd, you know, hit all my goals in life, maybe I'd then drop that much money on these. They are one of the most famous sandals of all time. They keep bringing them back in every color. Imagine just being able to drop £500 on a pair of leather sandals. They are super classy, super beautiful. I think they look great with jeans, great with skirts, and I've seen a lot of people wearing them. So they are definitely a fail-safe, great piece. However, I know that people like Topshop do similar if you are just looking for that similar all leather style. I love it because it's obviously got a really subtle logo of the H on the front. And if people know about fashion, they will know that you are wearing them. But for me, £495 is a little bit spenny, but there is a reason that people are obsessed with this. The H cut out, the silhouette, they're pretty classy. Speaking of leather sandals, that takes me on to my next pair, Zara. It had to be. I can't do a video and not talk about Zara sandals. I find Zara shoes are great. I think they are absolutely beautiful, particularly the leather ones. Do have a pair of shoes from there that absolutely looked amazing, and then a few weeks after wearing them, ripped my feet to shreds, but they're flat leather sandals with crisscross straps. Look to be a very hero sandal of the year. People are buying them like crazy, and I think it's because they have that crossover of the Chloe, but they're nice and chunky on the top. I just think they look so premium and designer, and they also have them in several colors, plus they're only $29.99. I personally like the beige ones. I'm pretty certain they're gonna sell out very soon, but everyone loves Zara. It's that kind of Spanish style, easygoing, looks very classic and very high-end without costing the earth. Next up, we are flying through these, the Gucci Double G Canvas Cider Sandals. I'm gonna order these in every color. No, not in every color. I wish I could afford to do that, but I'm definitely gonna order them in the brown and in the white to see which pair I like. What I would say about these is they're not just sliders that are gonna fall apart that you're gonna be able to wear for one season. They are actually really nice shoes as well, and I love that a lot of the sandals this year on the market are sandals that you can actually get wear out of. So some sandals, like maybe thong ones, you probably wouldn't maybe wear to a meeting, but these feel a lot more kind of like office appropriate as well, rather than just having like flip-flops on. They're a lot more kind of, you get a lot more shoe, a lot more bang for your buck. Next up, call me crazy, but the Doc Martin Clarissa sandals. I had never seen these before, and then all of a sudden everyone was searching for them. Everyone was talking about them. They're called quad sandals, and I think there's this real thing at the moment. People are loving that kind of thick, chunky sandals. We had the chunky trainer trend, now we've got the chunky sandal trend, and you know what? I'm not mad about it, actually. I quite like them. My best friend wears Doc Martens, and when she said she was buying them, I was like, what? I've never seen you in them, and they look amazing. I just think, when I looked at these shoes, I was like, you know, I actually think these work. These are cool. So they do them in white, they do them in black, they do them in pink. I like the pink ones, but I actually think the white ones are cool because they're monochrome. It depends on what kind of clothes you wear. Some people love wearing all black. I love wearing neutral colors, so for me, I think the pink ones or the white ones would be amazing. Super chunky, that traditional kind of Doc Martin look, but then actually really quite feminine with the way that they cross over, and I love sandals that go around the ankle. I just think they're really nice. I always tend to steer towards sandals that kind of tie up around the ankle. I just think they're really flattering. So yeah, it was a really interesting one. They're also £129, so not too expensive, not too cheap. Doc Martens are very well made, so they do tend to be expensive anyway. The next sandals that people are going crazy for, there's definitely a trend for leather sandals, is the YSL Tribute flat sandals. Now, I think they have a real similarity to the Hermes ones, but honestly, these are nice. They kind of have intertwining at the front. I really like the kind of simplicity of them. However, they are £440, and it's very similar to the ones I was talking about earlier when I said, if you have that kind of money to drop on a pair of very plain sandals, go for it. But I would rather drop that money on Gucci, because then everyone knows it's Gucci. Seriously, I just like my Gucci. I do think they are so beautiful. They look very streamlined, very lightweight, very easy to wear, and just super classic. And I know that they're something that will go with everything. If you don't want to drop that much money on a pair of sandals, I mean, I don't have that amount of money to drop on a pair of plain sandals, then I would recommend looking at some of the dupes that I'm gonna link below, because you can get similar, which also kind of puts me off buying the designer ones. At least with the Gucci ones, there is nothing similar. But yeah, I really like them. I think they're gorgeous smooth leather, and if money was no object, I'd go for them. Next up, and please excuse me if I'm saying this wrong in my Yorkshire accent, the Valentino Garavani sandals. So I actually saw my friend Josie wearing these, and when Josie wears something, you know it's gonna be a hit. You know that she's ahead of the fashion and it's gonna be a hit. These look so nice with a white dress, like a long white dress, and these, oh my god, they're just classic. So Valentino isn't my favorite brand, I'm not gonna lie, it's not, but oh my gosh, the world is Valentino obsessed. I'm not gonna lie, I'm quite glad we've moved away from the studded ones, and they've gone into this like really beautiful kind of elegant, not much there look. Like for me, this is really classy. It's just a beautiful brown slider leather with a gold logo, and I actually think they're really effortless. Obviously there's no back on them, so they're more of like a slider, but because they're leather, I feel like they are great quality, they're long lasting, and they just look so classy. Like I saw it on the picture with the model in the white dress, and I was like, oh my god, this might actually sway me to buy some Valentino. And they do these in a few other colors so it can suit your color palette. They have them in black, they have them in see-through. I would personally get them with brown just because I think brown goes really well with like nice white dresses and white jeans, but I know that a lot of people like wearing all black, so the black and gold ones might work for you. Also, I really like gold as a color. I think silver's quite cold, so for me, I love that the logo is gold. I think that's why I like Gucci as well. Give me the gold. These are $475 in true Valentino style. They're not the cheapest, but they're nice. Last but certainly not least, Chanel mules. Every time I go into Chanel at summertime, obviously I haven't been into a store for a long time, but when I was going to the store, there's literally one at the top of my road. Dangerous, I know. I just lust over the shoes. The bags are nice in Chanel, but have you seen the shoes? They do the most amazing mules and they are just stunning. I have my Chanel espadrilles. I keep buying them. I shouldn't because they get ruined. So now why not get the mules as well? I'm not going to get them because they're £770 and that's obscene. I could get 2.5 pairs of Gucci for the same price. I could get the Gucci's and the Valentino's. However, I have to talk about the Chanel mules because they're just beautiful and any footwear Chanel bring out is just divine. Yes, I love that it has a big CC logo on. I just love the colors. I love that they always do really beautiful neutral sandals. On these mules particularly, I love that they're a little bit elevated. I do a lot of walking, not that I would in Chanel. That's how I ruin things. And I love that they're kind of thicker on the bottom rather than like being really thin, so you're gonna ruin your feet. If money was no object, I'd have all the Chanel. So there we have it, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. Really different one from me, but there are so many trends at the moment and I just thought, why not talk about it? It might inspire one of your purchases. You might be able to find a dupe or you might find the designer pair of shoes of your dreams. Let me know if there's anything else you would like me to film. I'll link the dress below as well. If you haven't subscribed, it would mean so much if you could hit the subscribe button. And as I say, everything's gonna be linked below. Come say hi on Instagram at emtalks. Stay safe, guys. Sending you lots and lots of love, and I hope you enjoyed this.